Welcome to another Monday step-by-step tutorial. Today we continue the trigonometry series with how to solve 3D trig problems step-by-step. So if you have trouble with 3D trig problems, then make sure to stick to the end to see how it's done. All right, so what are 3D trig problems? Well, it's trigonometry in three dimensions. So what's step one? So draw a diagram of the 3D problem, right? And then this is important. So this is if the diagram's not given. But you've got to make sure to label each point, all the given values, the unknowns which you're going to have to find, and compass directions. Right? Because these are going to make step two a lot easier. Which is, so draw each relevant triangle, so the 2D version, from your diagram in step one. And relevant means it has given info or unknown values you need to find. So this is the trick for 3D trig. 3D trig problems are tricky and very hard to visualize. So what you do once you have your diagram, if they don't give it to you, is convert it to a 2D problem, because 2D problems are much easier to solve. So then what's step three? So step three, find the triangle that links all the diagrams in step two and use either basic trig, sine or cos rule to put all given and unknowns you can into that diagram. Because right, you'll have a few 2D triangles in here, but in order to answer the question, there's only going to be one triangle, main triangle, that we're going to use to answer the question to find the unknowns. So this is why it's important to label each point, because if you label each point, you'll be able to see which triangles link properly, which sides and angles go together. And then it's just a combination of basic trig, like your soccer toa or the sine and cos rule. They're the only things we've got to find sides and angles. Okay, so then that leads us to step four. So again, what happens now is, because we've got one main triangle to work with, all our unknowns and given info is in that diagram, we're just gonna either use basic, trig, sine or cos rule to find those unknown values. Because everything's in that one diagram, we've got our angles, our sides. So if it's a right angle triangle, we can use basic trig. If it's a non-right angle triangle, we'll use sine or cos rule. And that's pretty much it. So then the last step we've gotta do is write the answer in terms of the question. So you're going to get a value for your unknowns in here, but you're going to have to put that in terms of what the question's asking for. Okay, is it the height? Is it a bearing? So just some notes about bearings here. So when we have bearings, every north line is parallel to each other, right? Because the direction north is parallel to itself. So that means if we have multiple north lines, we can use our alternate angles, corresponding angles, or co-interior angles from geometry. So as you see, pretty much trigonometry is a combination of geometry as well. All right, so don't forget, we're gonna need to use basic geometry to help us. So look at this trick, the board's clean. All right, now that the board's clean, let's apply that step-by-step procedure for an example that covers pretty much most kinds of 3D trig problem. All right, so I've got the question here. You should be able to see in the corner here. The diagram shows two observers P and Q 600 meters apart on level ground. The angles of elevation of the top of T of a landmark TL from P to Q are 9 and 12 degrees respectively. All right, let's just draw a diagram. There's a diagram they gave us, right? Cool magic trick. So now, step one, so they've given us the basic diagram, which really helps, but now we're gonna label all the given info on that diagram. And they've labeled every point for us, which is very helpful. So they've told us P and Q are 600 meters apart. The angles of elevation are 9 degrees and 12 degrees respectively from P and Q. So this is 9 degrees here, 12 degrees here. And then they said the bearings of the landmark from P and Q are 32 degrees and 306 degrees. So if we include that, we need a north line at P and a north line at Q. And the bearing is along the ground. So L is on the ground, P to L. The bearing is this angle here, which they said was 32 degrees. And then the bearing from Q to L, which is along the ground here, which is this angle here, is 306 degrees. So if this complete angle is 306 degrees, that means what's left here is 54 degrees to get to 360 degrees. And then they've said, let H be the height of the landmark. So that's our unknown. So let's see everything. So find angle PLQ. All right, Don't need that anymore. So then we can go to step two. What's step two? Is draw each relevant 2D triangle. And we've got three here. We've got the base, which I'll put here. P, Q, and don't forget we've got these north lines added. It looks so north. 54 degrees and north here. 32 degrees, that's 600, and that's L. So that's that base diagram. Then we've got these two triangles here with the angles of elevation. So 9 degrees, P, T, L, and then the other one, L, 12 degrees. Don't forget H is here, H is there, Q, T. So that's step two done. We've taken every main 2D triangle from that question that has given info or unknowns. So now we're ready to start step three, but first, what we can do now is part one of the question just show that this angle PLQ is 86 degrees. So in order to do that, we need to use these bearings. So this is that note I made at the end about bearings. North lines are parallel to each other. So what I can do here is create another north line. That's another north line. So all these north lines are parallel to each other. So since we're trying to find the angle in here, you'll notice now that all these lines are parallel to each other, which means I can use alternate angles, corresponding or co-interior angles. And we can see here that this is a Z shape, so that is alternate angles. Straight away they're 32, and then straight away this is 54 degrees. So in total, you get 86 degrees for angle PLQ. Okay, so just make a note, by alternate angles, since north lines are parallel, we get 32, 54, which adds to 86. So that takes care of the first part. Then the next part of the question, just have a quick look. What is the size of angle BA? No, sorry, wrong question. Find expressions for PL and QL in terms of H. And why is that important? Because this is what step three talks about. This base diagram here relates everything, right? Because PL comes from this triangle, LQ comes from this triangle, and then this triangle has 600 and an angle. So this is the one triangle that relates everything. So now we need to use basic trig to put all the unknowns and given values onto this triangle, which is these two sides. So you can see here, using basic trig, tan 9 degrees equals H over PL. So that means PL is going to be, if we swap it, H over tan 9. And then we can just write, therefore, QL will be H over tan 12, because it's the exact same process except I swap 9 degrees for 12 degrees. So those are the two values for PL and QL which we put onto this diagram here to complete step 3. Alright, so at the end of step 3 you should have one diagram that has all sides and angles given in terms of the given info and unknowns, which we've got all these three sides and an angle in terms of given values and unknown values H. So in step four, so this was step three. Step four is now we need to use sine, cos rule, or basic trig to solve for the unknown, which is H. So look at this, it's a non-right angle triangle because we're only given 86 degrees. So that means straight away sine or cos rule. So the trick with sine or cos rule is just look at what you're given. I've got three sides and an angle. So what formula relates that? That is the cos rule. Right, only the cos rule, which is c squared equals a squared plus b squared minus 2ab cos c, has three sides we can plug in and an angle. Sine rule can't do that. So then if we plug it in with c being the side opposite the angle, you get 600 squared equals h squared on tan squared 9 plus h squared on tan squared 12 minus 2h squared cos 86 over tan 9 tan 12 just by timesing these sides together with cos 86. And now this is an equation where we need to solve for H. And the question says show H is approximately 79 meters. So what you'll notice is each of these has a H squared, which means I can factorize that out. 10 squared 9 plus 1 on 10 squared 12 minus 2 cos 86 on 10 9 10 12. That equals 600 squared, which means I can rearrange and square root. By dividing this over and square rooting, we get h equals 600 over, this looks fun, doesn't it? 1 on 10 squared 9 plus 1 on 10 squared 12 minus 2 cos 86 on 10 9 10 12. All right, and the reason we leave it as 1 on 10 squared 9 instead of changing it to cot is because the calculator does not have cot. So this is actually how you're going to have to type it into the calculator. Right, so now where's the answer? This thing was working to 4, so we can see we got the answer there, 78.88. the question said show equals approximately 79. Well, that just equals 79 meters if we round it up. Okay, so that's basically how 3D trig problems are solved step by step. For most problems are broken down like this, and either use sine or cos rule at the end here if it's a non-right angle triangle. Don't forget basic geometry helps such as Pythagoras and normal parallel lines. So that concludes this Monday step-by-step tutorial for how to solve 3D trig problems. Hope you guys enjoyed. Whoa, you made it to the end. Thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something awesome today. I post 6 videos a week, Monday to Saturday, so make sure to subscribe here, turn those bell notifications on, and watch other awesome videos on my channel right here, okay? Right here. Oh yeah, don't forget to like, comment, and share. Spread the maths love. Can we go to the gym now?